Thank you. Let's all stand. Everyone standing, please. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live again. And whosoever lives and believes in me shall never die. Man that is born of a woman has but a few days and full of trouble. Cometh forth as a flower and is cut down. And fleeth also as a shadow and continueth not. We brought nothing into this world, and it is certain we carry nothing out. The Lord gave, the Lord had taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Whom shall I be afraid? Lord, there has been a dwelling place in all generations before the mountains were brought forth, forever thou hast formed the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting. Good evening, everyone. I'd like to make you welcome this afternoon as we come to celebrate the life of departed Anthony Oscar Thompson. We praise the Lord for the life that he's lived. We pray this evening that as we come to celebrate this life, to return thanks to Almighty God for his journey on this land, we will also be cognizant of the fact that one day positions are going to be reversed. We may be in the casket, and then we'll be keeping a service for us. I'd like at this time, on behalf of my wife and the entire congregation, not only here at Calvary Baptist, but the Pentecostal Fellowship, to extend to the family our deepest and sincerest condolences. There has been a typographical error in the booklets when we come to the singing of the song. The goodness of God is not the one of your pamphlet, but will be one of the projecting. We'll begin with our goodness.
I love you, Lord. Oh, your mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in your hands. From the moment that I wake up till I lay my head, I will sing of the goodness of God. I know you as a father. For all my life you have been faithful.
All
my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. With my life laid down, I surrender now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after, it's running. Of the goodness of God. Oh, I will sing of the goodness of God.
Hallelujah. The goodness of God is what enables us all to be here this afternoon. And no man knows the end of this day. So we're going to have to open in prayer. Sister, I'll come out this time, which will be followed by first scripture reading, which will be done by someone this morning.
Our Father, which art in heaven, we look to you in the name of Jesus, your only begotten Son, the one that was resurrected, exalted, and ascended at the right hand of his majesty, there as our advocate, our elder brother, our intercessor, our mediator. Father, we are thankful that we can come and bow before your Lordship. No longer the partition wall or the ceremonial law. You took them all out of the way. You nailed them to your cross. And thank God you have opened the door of grace to all men so that we can come boldly this evening, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in the time of need. Father God, we are thankful to be alive. And we are thankful, oh God, for your infinite goodness, grace, and mercy. So far during the week, the prophet you have been, we are thankful for your providential care. Lord, we give you thanks, we give you praise, and we exalt and lift you up at this moment. Father, at this moment, we bring the family of the deceased before you. We pray, oh God, at this time you would hold them up in the very hollow of your hand. We pray, oh Lord, undergird them. We pray, oh God, Father, we'll keep them leaning on the everlasting arms of Christ. So God, they will... arms that will never grow weary and worn and tired. They will be sustained, oh God, in these times. Oh God, I pray at this time, Lord, they would even draw their strength from the word of God. Remembering Paul said to those at Thessalonica, he assured them that death is not the end. and they would meet with their loved ones again. They would be reunited. For he says that the trump will sound, and the voice of the archangel, and the dead in Christ will be raised first. And those that are alive and remain shall also be caught up, and they will meet in the air, and they will go together. And thank God, there's a blessed hope, even beyond the grave this afternoon. I pray, oh God, you'll keep this family covered under your precious blood. I pray, oh God, you will strengthen them at this hour. We know that death is inevitable. It is sure. It will come to every one of us. But thank God for the Redeemer that has given us a blessed hope, even beyond the grave this afternoon. Lord, we are praying even now for the continuation of this service. I pray, oh God, for the ministering servant of God. I pray, oh God, you would anoint that one and you would give unction. That God, as we would sit and listen, God, we'd be edified, we'd be built up, and we've been strengthened and encouraged in these times. Bless this afternoon, Holy God. Take over, Holy Spirit of God. It's my prayer with thanksgiving. Amen and amen.
Good afternoon. Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed. In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is always swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, for as much as ye know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord.
Program sheets, we will sing the song when we all get to heaven.
Sing the wondrous love of Jesus, sing his mercy and his grace. In the mansions bright and blessed, he prepared for us a place. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory. While we walk the pilgrim pathway, clouds will overspread the sky. But when traveling days are over, not a shadow, not a sign. What a day of rejoicing that will be.
See for a long time, you see them at funerals. But this afternoon I want to say a few words on behalf of Anthony Oscar Thompson, to many of us known as football. When I heard the name, I asked, "Are you a football player?" I said, "No." I said, "So why do they call you football?" He said, "I don't know. But it don't take none off of me, no, I don't put none on to me." And he never decided that I'm not going to answer for the name. He took the name, and he was comfortable with it. Anthony Oscar Thompson, known as football, of Guy Hill, St. Joseph, entered into rest peacefully on Monday the 13th of February, 2013, at the QEH. He was the son of the late Isleen and Albert Robbie Small, the proud father of Akeem Thompson, and a very proud grandfather of Azari Thompson. He was the brother of William Thompson, the late Bentley Small, Marva Small, Rufus Small, Elvin, Corita Small, Chandler, Elma Small, Bronte Small, Marlene Small, Nicholas, Glenda Small Anderson, Theophilus Watts, Maureen Kelman. And these are his siblings. He was a proud uncle of 27, great uncle of 37, brother-in-law of Pastor Yvonne Small, Arula Small, Andrea Small, Hardcore Anderson, Juanita Walk, Sylvia Thompson, and the late John Chandler. Relatives of the Small, Thompson, Hoyt, and Cumberbatch families. Good friend, or a great friend of Rufus Griffith. Anthony was a devoted father. And for those of you who knew Anthony, knew that he was a perfectionist. If he's going to do something, he's going to do it and do it well. If you ask him to do something and he say, I'm going to do it for you, if it is midnight, he would still come to do it. And if he say no, rest assured that all the persuasion that you try to do, he has already made up his mind and it wouldn't change. That is a man that I knew as a friend. I remember him working as a mechanic. And there was a Mitsubishi truck that was giving some problems, and I asked Anthony to fix the truck. And he looked at me and told me, you see that? Man, if I can't get it fixed, nobody can fix it. I'm the best in my business. I said to him, but everybody tried. He said, but I ain't tried yet, the best ain't tried yet. And a few days it was up and running, he come back to me and he told me, man, what I tell you, if the boss can't get it fixed, nobody can get it fixed. And he was proud of his trade. And he did it with pride. I remember him working at the transport board. And that is where we got real close. For over 50 years, we were friends. And we used to share our darkest secrets. And we would share the good times and the bad times. There are things that he would say to me, Ruth, boy, I got something to tell you. But this is for your ears only. Nobody else but me and you. And it remained with me up to this day. If he telling me something and it's for my ears only, it means that he don't want me to divulge of it. So that is the relationship that we had and the friendship that we carried through the years. And he went to the Technical Institute. At that time, the Technical Institute, which is now the Samuel Jackman Prescott. It was at the Harbour Road, right by the roundabout, by the Port Gap. And I remember Anyway, he was the he was the one in charge of the institute. And the boys, you know, when young men get together and no one in charge is there, what would happen? They'll start their own conversation, they'll start their own jokes. And he came in and he said to them, you are not here for making jokes. You are here to learn a trade. And when you leave here, I want you to be, the best that you can be. The gentleman named was Mr. Bayer. And Mr. Bayer continued to put it in the heads of those youngsters that went to that institute. Do not leave here the same way that you came in. Make sure that when you leave here, that the lessons that are taught here, that you would be able to teach someone else some of the things that I teach you, and that you would be able to go through life a better man than when you came in. And Anthony said, from that day for that night forward, because they used to go to evening classes, from that night, I pull up my socks. And I start looking at what was on the board and listening to every word that my teachers told me. because I wanted to be, to make a difference when I leave that institution. Through the years, we had some very good conversations, and we share most everything. I said most everything, not everything. And I'm not going to explain to you what I mean, but not everything. But according to old people, you could pick meaning from that. We would call one another very often. And we would talk, and we would talk. I started to go back to church, and I said to him, boy, I'm back in church, and I'm serving the Lord. He said, I can get there one day, man, don't worry. Not far from now. I said, I'm hoping that it would be sooner rather than later. When Anthony accepted Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, the Sunday afternoon, he called me and he said, I joined the Happy Band of Pilgrims. I said, praise the Lord. And from that day forward, every time that Anthony called me, you better believe that he has some passage of scripture that he's going to push down my throat. And I said to myself, but he don't get saved and this man converted me. And I mean, like, I would tell him, yes, Pastor Thompson, you can be soon pastoring some church, boy. You traveling fast. Keep it up. And we would make our jokes. But we always share the scriptures. Sometimes we go into a subject. And he knew that I'm a trained theologian. He knew that because when I was studying, I told him. And he knew when I was studying theology. And I said to him, I don't want to pastor a church. I want to be able to understand the word of God. And I want to be able to teach the word of God to anyone that I come in contact with. And those that want to learn. Because all you tell people and they don't want to learn is a waste of time. And we would continue to, just from Bible verse, from one passage of scripture to the next, to the other one. And I would say to him, you know, I am so happy that we all are walking on the straight and narrow path and that you're reading your Bible, because the only way that you can grow in Christ is by reading your Bible and praying. The two goes together. And we would always, you know, encourage one another in the Lord. We would always find time to share the scriptures. And I remember after he retired, he said, you retired a few years ago, but now I got time to serve the Lord and to work my ground. Just like that. I said, so we'll be doing it together, because we'll be doing devotions whenever you are available, so that we will grow together. Because we don't understand that when Christ saves us, it is not only for us to rejoice that we are saved, but we are supposed to go out there in the highways and the hedges and compel and encourage the lost ones to come to Christ. Sometimes we sit down in our comfort zones and we don't remember even our family members who don't know Christ. But Jesus died for all. And it is our duty to encourage one another. We are supposed, the scripture tells us, encourage one another in the Lord. So that is what we used to do. I remember when Akeem was born. And he said, boy, I am so proud today. I said, Winnie Lotto? He said, man, Winnie Lotto? You've been something better than that. He said, you got a bouncing baby boy. I said, good for you. He said, now I got something to live for. I mean, and he was so happy. When he had his son, he said, but when I hold that boy in my arm, I don't want to put it down here. I said, but how are you going to work for him if you don't put it down here? You got him. I said, when you get his spare time, you can go and you can pick him up. But now you got to work because you have someone to work for. And all he used to talk about is my son. He said, but you know, you can't do no foolishness wrong me. Can't come around me with no foolishness. No, you can't bring the bad company at me. That is the type of disciplinarian that Anthony was. And I came to attest to this, that his father would tell him something once. Once. And you better do it, or you'll pay the price. Now you know what that price would be. Some good lashes. And never once did Anthony told me that Akeem was a disobedient child. He said, man, I'm proud of that boy, man. He made my heart, he blessed my heart day after day. I don't know when he is not at home or when he with his friends what he would do. But I can assure you that he is respectful and he listens. So during those years when Akeem was growing up, all Anthony used to talk about is my son. When he went into secondary school, he was the proudest father in the world. He said, boy, you don't know. I am so happy. I did not have the opportunity to go to secondary school, but thank God that he can send you. That is the type of person that Anthony was. He was happy that his only son could go to secondary school when he was not afforded the opportunity to go. Because back in those days, you had to pay school fees. And it wasn't easy to buy food for the more pay school fees for poor people. So Anthony's legacy will live on in the hearts of us that knew him. And let me say this. Before he died, I went to the hospital to look for him. And Marlene was at the hospital. And I started to talk to Anthony. And when he began to cry, tears come from my eyes. Because I know that in his heart, he was sad. Because here's a man that would get up on mornings and go in that line and he would work till he ready to go home to cook. And now he's in the hospital bed. And it hurt me. I said, look, we all go through our trials and we all have our crosses to bear. I said, but you know Christ. Put your trust in him. He is able and more able to carry through the dark valleys than anyone else. And in a few more days, God called Anthony to his eternal home. There's a void that is left in the hearts of those of us, not only that had contact with Anthony, but those of us that was close to him that love him as the person that he was. And let me say to you that if there was a problem and I called Anthony at midnight, he would leave St. Joseph and he would come to St. Stephen's Hill, Black Rock, St. Michael. And if he had a problem, I would leave from home and I would drive to Guy's Hill. Because we never thought it too hard or too far to go from our home, from his home to my home, or from my home to his home. Because Bronte is sitting right there and she could tell you that one day she and Keith and Anthony came to my home and Anthony told her, Bronte, this is my brother from another mother. We are friends for life. Our friendship will not break up as long as we live. Thank God that his words did not fall to the ground. We were friends up to his death. And he will live on in our hearts. As long as we live. I can't say forever, because we are not going to live forever, not until we meet Christ as our Savior. But his memory and legacy will live on in us. And believe me, I have a lot of things that I wrote here, but I like to be led by the Holy Spirit. All that I've read from the eulogy that I wrote here is his siblings. But the Holy Spirit have led me down the road that God wanted me to speak to you this afternoon. And when we are living close to God and we are obeying the voice of the Spirit, God will take over. And when God takes over, his blessings will fall on each and every one of us. May he rest in peace and rise in glory. And to the family, I pray that God will continue to comfort you all and help you to live close to each other, because life is short. We are here today and we are gone today. We see you tomorrow, but we are here today and we are gone tomorrow. And we understand that we must live as Christians every day, every moment of every day as our last. We don't have tomorrow put down. May God continue to bless you all. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you, Mr. Griffin. That is an example of true friendship. I just like to borrow the humanness from phrase that was used. He said, if your boss can't fix it, nobody can. And for those of you who are facing the vicissitudes of life, I'd like to say to you this evening, there's a man called Jesus who can fix it. Cannot fix it, then certainly cannot be fixed, but there's nothing impossible with him. I notice at funerals that men don't like to come in the church. And I wonder why. Come in. A good place to be in the house of the Lord. Those two friends made sure, one got saved early and he made sure he let the other one know, I am on the Lord's side now. And this is how it should be. I made a statement to the church I had the honor to lead. Some people thought
but sin. I said, if all of us got all of our family members saved, then there would be no room in the church for anybody else. I don't know how people could accept a statement like that. Family is important. And particularly in this day and age in which we live, I'm going to Sister Misha, get ready to come to do your solo. And after you do your solo, we're going to have Psalm 46 prayed by Terry Thompson. But let me drop this up here. My daughter has a great niece who is just 4 years old. She went to the Maria Holder nursery school, and she's now, this year, she's stone got transferred to Sharon Primary. She came home on evening last week and she said, Auntie Bonga, tell me something. Are you a male or female? I go to explain to her, you know very well what I am. I make the point that our children are being taught some serious stuff in school. They're introducing this gender business. But my Bible tells me that God created male and female. There is no other gender. I will run down with it. Immigration officer and the passport form, it says other. And I ask him, what do I mean? Male, female, other. I said, that should never be on a form. Because God didn't make no other. You're either male, or you're only going to talk to me this evening, or female. And if you are other, then you are operating in the earth realm illegally. You are a disembodied spirit and you're going to be here. Because every thing in the earth realm that has the capacity, the ability to reproduce, Jesus, comes with male or female. When God got them to come into the ark, he told Noah, bring two of every kind, male and female. All right, all right. Michelle, come and rescue me before I get out of control this evening. I'm glad for this report for Brother Thompson. Amen.
Amen. Amazing grace, how sweet the song that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fail, and grace my faith relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believe. My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me. Mercy
Amazing grace, the Lord has promised good to me. His word, my hope secured. He will my shield and portion be. As long as life endures, my chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me. And like a flood, His mercy reigns, unending love, amazing grace. The earth shall soon dissolve like snow. The sun forbear to shine, but God who called me here below will be forever mine, will be forever mine. You are my chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me. And like a flood, His mercy rain, unending love. Amen. Amazing grace, unending love, amazing grace.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Bless his name. Bless his
name. Good evening. Here beginneth the lesson. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore will we not fear, though the earth be removed, and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea. Though the waters thereof roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with the swelling thereof, Selah. There is a river, the streams whereof shall make glad the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacles of the Most High. God is in the midst of her, she shall not be moved. God shall help her, and that right early. The heaven raged, the kingdoms were moved. He uttered his voice, the earth melted. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge, Selah. Come, behold the works of the Lord, what desolations he hath made in the earth. He maketh wars to cease unto the end of the earth. He breaketh the bow and cutteth the spear in sunder. He burneth the chariot in the fire. Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the heathen. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Selah. Here, end of the lesson.
We will stand at this time as we sing from our leaflets, God be the Lord.
To God be the glory, great things he hath done, so loved he. You turn my weakness into worship. You turn my pressure into praise. You turn my mourning into dancing. And I will bless your holy name. You turn my weakness into worship. You turn my pressure into praise. You turn my mourning into dancing. And I will bless your holy name. You turn it around. 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 And I say, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, you turn it around. 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 Lord, yes, Lord, you turn it around. You turn my weakness into worship. You turn my pressure into praise. You turn my mourning into dancing. And I will bless your holy name. You turn it around. Lord, yes, Lord, you turn it around. You turn my weakness into worship. You turn my pressure into praise. You turn my mourning into dancing. And I will bless your holy name. You turn my weakness into worship. You turn my pressure into praise. You turn my mourning into dancing. And I will bless your holy name. You turn it around. 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 And I say, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, you turn it around.
May stand in us. And welcome to the microphone for a proclamation of the word of the Lord. Pastor, you know, so hear her for her grace.
Thank you. Praise the name of the Lord. Blessed good evening to each and every one of you. Praise the name of the Lord. We give God thanks for His goodness. We give God thanks for His mercy. Praise the name of the Lord. And just praise the name of the Lord. Anthony, praise the name of the Lord. Our better known to us as Anne or football. Praise the name of the Lord. But what I want to say this evening, you can receive. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. We bless God this evening. Praise the name of the Lord. I can say and praise the name of the Lord. Anthony never leave me. Never. Praise the name of the Lord. And you know, praise the name of the Lord. It's not easy. Praise God. Because as the brother was giving the eulogy and spoke about the land and working the land, whenever he worked that land, he would call me. And he would say, come and get this. Come and get that. Praise the name of the Lord. And he was always there. We would talk. Praise the name of the Lord. And the last, I spoke with him January when the year turned. Praise the name of the Lord. And just about the same week that he went to hospital, I called for him. And the phone rang and rang and rang till it rang off. I didn't pay any attention. I just, maybe he's on the outside, maybe he's gone out. That was my first thought. But then to learn later that he was in hospital, praise the name of the Lord. And you know, to know that you didn't get that final opportunity to speak to him. This is why we must always be ready, because we don't know what a day will bring forth. Praise the name of the Lord. And calling for him as usual, as we exchange conversation and not hearing him, then to hear what takes place, and then to hear he gone from being sick, whatever, the death, praise the name of the Lord. And it was not easy, but I am humbled this afternoon, praise the name of the Lord, to be able to minister the word, praise the name of the Lord. And the word is not for him. The word is for those of us that are alive. The word is for those of you that are in the hearing of my voice. And we're going to look, praise the name of the Lord, to that first scripture that was read. 1 Corinthians chapter 15 and verses 51. Praise the name of the Lord. And it reads thus. Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed. And my topic this evening, a change is coming.
Oh, yes it is.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Yes, Lord.
A change is coming. And you and I know and understand change.
Yes,
some people change for the better. Some people change for the worse. Praise the name of the Lord. We go to bed as ladies. We go to bed. And we get up one morning and we just decide we're going to change the furniture. We decide, praise the name of the Lord, we are tired of seeing the paint on the house. So we are going to change the color of the paint. Whether it's on the inside, whether it's on the outside, we are making a change. Praise the name of the Lord. So many different things, praise the name of the Lord, in life that speak about changes. And I tell you, praise God, the world is longing for change. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Praise
the word is crying out for change.
Yes.
Praise the name of the Lord. But this evening I want us to know that there's a man called Jesus. Hallelujah.
Yes,
that
Jesus
is going to change things.
Yes.
I want us to know, praise the name of the Lord. There's a man. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And his name is Jesus.
Yes.
Even this word, change, come up. You have a sick relative. Praise the name of the Lord.
Yes.
You want to know how the relative is doing.
Yes.
The first word that come up your mouth, is there any change?
Yes. Yes.
Sometimes you don't even want to hear the answer. Because it's always not a change for the better.
Uh-huh.
But sometimes it's a change for the worse. But Jesus is going to make everything better.
Yeah.
Hallelujah, Jesus. A change, praise God, is coming. We long for change. Praise the name of the Lord. The whole creation is groaning.
Yes.
Praise God.
Yes.
But this man called Jesus, hallelujah, he is going to bring a change.
Yes,
blessed
ma'am.
Be the name of the Lord.
Yes.
And I just want us to know the same thing. That change can include you.
Yeah.
And that change can include me. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Praise the name of the Lord. The word tells us, we will not all sleep, praise God, but we will all be changed.
Amen.
Jesus is going to change the situation.
That's correct.
Jesus is going to change the circumstances because he has the final say.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Yes,
it might be heartaches now. Yes, it might be pain now. We pay me a joy for the night.
Joy.
But joy, it comes in the morning. Amen. And a change is coming. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Jesus will turn it around for us. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. And one man by the name of Job. Oh, bless God. Hallelujah. All that he's been through, all that he suffered, he declared all the days of my appointed time.
Amen.
I will wait till my change come.
Yeah.
My change is going to come. Hallelujah.
Yes,
Jesus, yeah. Praise the name of the Lord.
Uh-huh.
He's going to change things for us.
Yes, he is.
He's going to make it better.
Mm-hmm.
Mankind will not make it better.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
He is going to change our good bodies. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Oh, we're going to change from corruption into corruption. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. This corruption will put on incorruption. Hallelujah. Praise God, this mortality will put on immortality. Praise the name of the Lord. Glory be to God. He's going to bring a change. Hallelujah. Change is coming. Glory be to God. And we look forward for the change. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Death, it will be all over. It will be swallowed up in victory. Oh, death, where is thy sting? Ah, it is a sting. Hallelujah. It hurts. It robs us of our loved ones. It robs us of those that are good to us. Praise the name of the Lord. It robs us. But bless God, it's coming today. When the sting will be taken out of death. Hallelujah. Oh, sting. Oh, death. Praise thy sting. Oh, grave. Praise thy victory. Hallelujah, Jesus. The Lord himself. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. He will change the situation. Praise the name of the Lord. The Lord Jesus himself. Glory to God. And those of us that are looking for real change, those of us that are looking for genuine change, praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm not speaking about the change in the natural now. I'm speaking about the change in the spiritual. I'm speaking about a relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. I'm speaking about changing sin for salvation. I'm talking about swapping partners this evening.
Yes.
Giving up on the old enemy.
Yes.
To follow the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Praise the name of the Lord. Because this whole world, it will not continue forever.
Mm.
Things will not go on forever as it looking as it seems. The whole world is in turmoil. The whole world is in crisis. And there are those, hallelujah, that are crying out. Ah, Jesus, the poor. Hallelujah, the needy.
Yes.
Oh, glory to God. Those, hallelujah, that are less fortunate. They are crying out. But glory to God. You can be a part of this change.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah. You can be a part of this change. Because the Lord Jesus Christ, hallelujah, was looking to mankind to change the situation, to change the circumstances, to turn it around and perform miracles. I say in my name is Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
His name is Jesus.
Oh, yes.
He's the one that is going to bring the change.
Yeah.
He's the one. Praise the name of the Lord. That is going to, praise God, make everything new.
Yes.
You're going to change. You understand change?
Mm-hmm.
When you're going to change your furniture, you put it outside, you give it away, and you bring it something new. Hallelujah, Jesus is going to do away with you all. Hallelujah, I'm bringing new.
Yes.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Church, hallelujah, a change is coming.
Yes.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah, Anthony has, hallelujah, answered. Praise God, his call. He has kept his appointment.
Mm-hmm.
Because there's nothing that he could do about it. Nothing. nothing you and I can do about our appointment. Praise God, so this message is not for him. You can't hear a thing we are saying this evening. This message is for those of us, hallelujah, that are in the land of the living. We need to know, glory to God, that the Lord Jesus Christ is going to change things. The Lord Jesus Christ is going to turn around things. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Many a times you weep, you mourn, you lament. Praise the name of the Lord. You yourself with your fortune situation. You yourself with your fortune circumstances that you can do more. But recognizing we have more limitations, but thank God, Jesus declared, all power, hallelujah, is given unto me in heaven and in earth, and to as many as receive them, to them will give the power to become the sons of the living God. What we can't do, our Lord and Savior. He will do. He will do. Praise God. A change is coming. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And there's nothing, praise God, that any one of us can do about it. Nothing, praise God, to stop it. Praise the name of the Lord. One day, hallelujah, as I mentioned, that the trumpet will sound. Hallelujah. The living righteous will hear the trumpet. The dead in Christ will hear the trumpet. If you're not in that category, you will not hear it. Right. Praise the name of the Lord. It is for those that have been changed.
Yes.
It is for those that have been washed. It is for those that have prepared to meet the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. So those of us that are alive, hallelujah, and I trust God I will be among the living. Praise God. Will not stop those that are already dead. Praise God. But hear that trumpet song. I don't care where the people of God is. You're coming up. I don't care how many coffins on top of you.
Yeah.
I don't care how many fishes you. I don't care, praise the name of the Lord.
Jesus.
Hallelujah. Because a change is coming.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes,
praise God. It matters not how many persons have gone into that hole. It matters not the cap on your body at sea. But Jesus will find it. Save or unsave, Jesus will find it. A change is coming.
Yes, please.
Hallelujah.
Yes,
praise God. And as we have come up, those of us that are alive, and we remain, we caught up with them. See us going up in the air. Hallelujah. Family members, get up. Oh, glory to God in the arm of yours. And the calling.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. You see my mother.
Yeah.
Oh, you see my father.
Lord,
you see my brother.
Jesus.
You see my sister.
Yeah.
Glory to God. At some point in time, it will dawn on them the resurrection of the just and the unjust. Hallelujah. Of the just. Praise God. Not the unjust as we said. The resurrection of the just has taken place. And we are born. We are changed. Praise God as we go up.
Yes.
Because the word of God says, this corruption, this it may be changed. It cannot. Hallelujah. So those of us, praise the name of the Lord. Those of us that love Christ. Those of us that fall asleep in Christ. Those of us that are alive in Christ. No matter, praise God, how the foot hurt. No matter sickness, no matter disease, glory to God, a change is coming. The time for them will come.
Yes.
There will be no more, hallelujah, because the Lord Jesus, hallelujah, he's going to change change our behavior. We need to change our attitude. We need to change our ways. Praise the name of the Lord. And the only way we can live this life is by giving over to the Lord Jesus Christ. Praise the name of the Lord.
Yes.
But thank God. Hallelujah. Jesus here. Praise God. Death is swallowed up in victory.
Yes.
We have victory. Praise God. I know up to this point in time, man cannot come to grips with death. Cannot. It's an old enemy.
Yeah.
That's why the word of God declares the last enemy that shall be destroyed is death.
Yes.
Praise God.
Yes.
So even that, Jesus is going to take care of. Uh-huh. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. And I trust and I pray this afternoon, glory to God, that you will be part of the change. Hallelujah. You'll be a part of the life that the Lord Jesus Christ has offered to us. Now we are in the Lenten season. Now we are in the time when we remember the sufferings of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Yes,
we are in the times when we remember he was wounded for our transgressions.
Uh-huh.
He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. And by his strength, by his strength, by his strength,
yes,
we are healed. Yes. Oh, glory to God. A chain is coming.
Yes,
let it be for the better for you.
Yes,
hallelujah. A chain is coming. Glory to God, he's suffering. He gave his life a ransom.
Yes.
What more can Jesus do? He laid the foundation.
Open
he opened up the way. What more do we want Jesus to do? Hallelujah. But we trust that when the Lord Jesus Christ should put in his appearance, all those that sit here this evening, you may never come back to church for another funeral. Hallelujah. Ah, but the word of God,
God,
I trust it ring in your ears.
Yes.
I trust it pricked into your heart.
Oh,
Jesus, I trust that change will come. Hallelujah, in the life of those sitting on the word of God, at the hearing of the voice. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. A change is coming. Church, a change is coming. I can't tell you when, but you're coming.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah!
Yeah.
And I believe you're coming. And we must all be ready.
Yes.
Praise the name of the Lord to accept our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Praise the name of the Lord. God bless you this evening. Just want to take a few minutes to extend sympathy on behalf of the Calvary Baptist. And I praise the name of the Lord and membership here. And I extend our deepest sympathy to the family members. Praise the name of the Lord. Friends, praise God. Again, you have my deep sympathy. Praise the name of the Lord. May God strengthen you. Praise God. God bless you. Praise God. Praise you. Hallelujah!
Thank you, Pastor Small. The Lord bless you.
Hallelujah!
A change.
Jesus!
It's coming. It's inevitable.
Hallelujah.
Thing that bothers me is that a lot of people today seem to think that when we talk about heaven and hell, when we talk about the return of the Lord Jesus Christ, when we talk about salvation, seem to them like it's a Nancy story. When we talk about Christ returning, there are those who still say, but I hear that ever since. But he's closer this afternoon than he was yesterday. And it beholds every one of us to make our calling an election sure. Listen, even as sure as you will die one day, even more certain is the fact that Jesus is coming again. Because he said it, and he cannot lie. It's impossible for him to lie.
Hallelujah.
I wish, as I told the church on Sunday morning, The Lord had given me the kind of authority he gave the angel who went down to Sodom. The Bible says that Lot was in there and his family, and they were dilly-dallying. The angel hastened Lot, reached out and had to grab him and pull him out. Oh, this evening, if you're here and you don't know Jesus, you'll never have a better opportunity than this evening. You heard the report of Brother Anthony, how he served the Lord, how he kept up his relationship with God, his passion, his zeal for the Lord. And that's why we preach and plead the way we do, because knowing the terror of the Lord, we persuade men this evening. I was contemplating a few things to say. During the night, the Lord said to me, let the congregation know that out of death came life. That's why Jesus came. He died so you don't have to die. Oh, Lord Jesus. Hey.
Hallelujah.
The grave and death had a conversation concerning Jesus. The grave said, what you gonna do with him? Death said, well, if I sting him, can you hold him? The grave said, yes. All you have to do is sting him. I'll hold him. But early Sunday morning,
yes,
Jesus got up. You see, he's resurrection and life. Can I tell you this evening that resurrection is not an event, it's a person. Jesus declared, I am the resurrection and I am the life. And therefore, grave or death cannot triumph over resurrection and life. Thank God this evening the door is open. You can know the Lord Jesus as your Savior. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. This sermon this evening will probably be the last sermon some of you are going to hear. For some of you this evening sitting here, the sickness that will take you out is already in your body. Your spot is already marked out in the cemetery. And if I were you, in the next 2 minutes as we prepare to close this service, I wouldn't leave here without making a commitment to the Lord. You could say and testify that at the funeral of Brother Anthony Thompson, I said yes to the Lord. You bow your heads. You're here this evening. You don't know Jesus as your Savior, you're not saved, just lift your hand if you want to receive Him. Anybody want to be saved this evening? They want to say yes to the Lord. Now, a lot of people who left and have gone into eternity would be glad for an opportunity like you have right now. But the book is closed. The final chapter has been written. There's nothing they can do about it. But you are in time, and you're not in eternity. While the Spirit of the Lord speaks to you this evening, would you say yes to God? We're not asking you to join the church. We're asking you to prepare for this change that is coming. Listen to me. If you don't change your lifestyle now, When the trumpets sound, you're not going up. For if the same spirit that raised Christ from the dead dwells in you, the same spirit that quickened Christ will quicken your mortal body, and he'll raise you up. Father, we thank you for your word. We thank you for the opportunity you've given us this evening. For you said, how shall they hear if there is no preacher? You've given a preacher. You've given your word. And so, Father, the onus is on the hearers this evening. But I pray that even, Lord God, as you were merciful to Lot and his family, be merciful for those who sit here this evening. Let this word resonate in their spirits. Father, open their eyes that they may catch a glimpse of you. Open their ears, Lord, that they may hear what the Spirit is saying. God, turn their hearts to you, that they may own you as their Lord and as their Savior. I pray for the family. Lord, this gentleman, from all reports, lived an exemplary life. If there are members of the family that are not saved, would you please gather them to you, Lord? In the name of Jesus, thou who art the great comforter, comfort them now. You are a God of all comfort. Lord Jesus, the psalm said that you are our refuge. You are a present help in trouble. Be with them as they mourn. Be with them as they grieve. Let them not be depressed, but let hope spring forever in their bosoms. Let them remember, Lord, how he boasted on you, how he talked of your goodness. And I pray, Lord, you cover this family in your blood. Undergird them with strength. Knit them close together. For sometimes, Lord, after death, Father, there are wranglings in family. Let there be none this evening. But let this family lean upon each other. Draw strength from each other. That, Lord, they would be comforted by your grace and by your spirit. In Jesus' name. Amen. Now I'm going to invite you to stand as we sing our closing hymn, I'll Fly Away.
Some glad morning when this life is over, fly away to a home of God's lecture shore. When I die, hallelujah, by and by. When I die, hallelujah, by and by,
blessed good afternoon to all of you, and I welcome you here to the St. Joseph Parish Church Cemetery as we join now in the second part of Christian burial for our departed brother Anthony Oscar Thompson. May God in Christ through our Lord Jesus Christ grant you peace and comfort as we commit his mortal remains to the earth. Everyone the Father gives to me will come to me. I will never turn away anyone who believes in me. He who raised Jesus Christ from the dead will also give new life to our mortal bodies through his indwelling spirit. My heart, therefore, is glad and my spirit rejoices. My body also shall rest in hope. I heard a voice from heaven saying, write this, happy are the dead who die in the faith of Christ. Henceforth, says the Spirit, they may rest from their labors, for they take with them the record of their deeds. In the midst of life, we are in death. To whom can we turn for help? But to you, Lord, who are justly angered by our sins. Lord God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, holy and most merciful Savior, deliver us from the bitter pains of eternal death. You know the secrets of our hearts. In your mercy, hear our prayer. Forgive us our sins, and at our last hour, let us not fall away from you. In sure and a certain hope of resurrection to eternal life, through our Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to Almighty God our brother Anthony Oscar, and we commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. And we beseech you in your infinite goodness to give us grace to live in your dear love and to die in your favor, that when your well-beloved Son shall come again in judgment, both this, our brother Anthony Oscar, and we ourselves may be found acceptable in your sight. Grant this for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Be with you. Let us bow our heads in prayer. Almighty God, with whom still live the spirits of those who die in the Lord, and with whom the souls of the faithful are in joy and felicity, we give you heartfelt thanks for the good examples of all your servants who, having finished their course in faith, now find rest and refreshment. May we with all who have died in the true faith of your holy name have perfect fulfillment and bliss in your eternal and everlasting glory, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Grant, O Lord, to all who are bereaved the spirit of faith and courage, that you may have the strength to meet the days to come with steadfastness and patience, not sorrowing as those without hope, but in thankful remembrance of God's great goodness and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those you love. And this we ask in the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Rest eternal grant unto him, O Lord. May he and all the faithful departed through the mercies of God rest in peace. Amen. The Lord bless him and keep him. The Lord make his face to shine upon him and evermore be gracious unto him. May the Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon him and give him peace now and forevermore. Amen.
Thank you.
We begin with our first hymn now, and we sing the hymn, Come We That Love the Lord, and Let Your Joys Be Known. Join in the song with sweet accord. Join in the song with sweet accord. And thus surround the throne. And thus surround the throne. We are marching to Zion. Beautiful, beautiful Zion. We are marching upward to Zion, the beautiful city of God. Service for my Lord, dark may be the night, but I'll cling more close to him. He will give me light. Satan's sneers may vex my soul, turn my thoughts aside, but my Lord goes ahead, leads whate'er betide. The hymn, as I journey through the land.
Simple, simple, simple,
To be with you. Let us bow our heads in prayer. Father in heaven, you gave your son Jesus Christ to suffering and to death on the cross and raised him to life in glory. Grant us a patient faith in time of darkness and strengthen our hearts with the knowledge of your love. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Remember, O Lord, this your servant who has gone before us with the sign of faith, and now rests in the sleep of peace. According to your promises, grant to him and to all who rest in Christ refreshment, light, and peace. And may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and forevermore. Amen. We sing the closing hymns, Precious Memories, Unseen Angels, and When a Peace Like a River Attendeth My Way, as the floral tributes are laid.
Thank you. to God, you guys, to give him families and all of us.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. May the divine assistance remain with us always, and may the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercies of God, rest in peace. Amen. On my own behalf and on behalf of the congregational family of St. Joseph and St. Aidan, I take this opportunity to offer to you, the friends and the relatives of our departed brother, Aunt Anthony Oscar, our deepest condolences. Be assured of the prayers of the church in this your time of bereavement, and evermore remember the eternal God is your refuge. Underneath are the everlasting arms. May God grant you peace and comfort in the days ahead, and may you continue to remember your loved one with joy and affection. God bless all of you, and may God grant you journeying mercies in this evening hour. I thank you. Thank you.
I get another one.